Hey everyone, this is just a quick video, diet tips, I guess. I keep getting asked if there's any diet tips and tricks I know aside from surgery to help someone lose weight. Now, I kind of do, but I kind of don't. I know the tips that I was told post-op and pre-op to help, and so I'm going to share those little tidbits and some other things that I know that might help you guys. First of all, Optifast is your best friend. Comes in packages that look like this. I don't really have any left. This is all I have, so I can't show you the box, unfortunately, but you can easily look it up. It's Optifast. And this is very low calorie diet. You mix one of these with 200 milliliters of water. And these come in shakes, different flavored shakes. They come in bars, like snack bars, desserts, and soups. Optifast is really good. It tastes really, really, really good. The problem is, in the States, you have to have a prescription for it, probably because people will abuse it. In New Zealand, luckily, you can just go into a chemist pharmacy and you can buy it. I don't know how it is in other places in the world, but they do have an online store, so maybe you can buy it there, or I don't know if eBay would have it or something. But I get a box of 21 of these. That's 7 days worth. It's a whole week's worth because it's 3 a day and a snack. And they have three different stages of it. And pre-op, because this is the pre-op diet here. Pre-op diet, what you do is you make them in advance so that they're cold, of course. And you just mix it with water. You don't need milk. So what I would do is I would make up a week's worth, have it in the fridge, wake up in the morning, have one shake for breakfast, nothing else. For lunch, you have one shake and you have 2 cups of green vegetables. You can have more, but you should not have less. And then for dinner, you can have meat. I think for lunch you can have meat as well. Don't quote me on that. Some form of protein, like an egg or like 100 grams of meat or 150 grams of meat or 200 grams. I don't know. You'd have to look it up yourself. It's been a while since I've taken it, obviously almost a year, so I don't really remember, but it's only green veggies. I do know that. And then maybe something to eat at lunch and then meat at dinner. Pretty sure lunch and dinner are the same, where you get your little bit of protein and you get your 2 cups or more vegetables, and you get your shake. You can also have a nighttime dessert, which is usually a shake. It's not like any dessert. You can have sugar-free candy and stuff, but the less you eat, obviously, the more weight you lose. So what I did was I traded in one of my boxes of shakes for a box of bars. At night, I would not have my dinner time shake. I would leave it, and I would have a before-bed snack instead. That before bed snack would be my bar. This way I'd be watching and I'd be snacking and I'd get that urge to snack out of my system, so I'd feel like I was still able just to snack and eat and watch, because I was so ingrained on sitting, watching, and eating that it was really hard to break out of. You can have whatever toppings you want. Again, if you start the program, you'll be able to know all the details of whatever program you're starting. This is just what I remember. This is just a basic guideline to show you how easy it is. What this does is your body goes, it's a ketogenic, I think it's called, diet. Your body starts producing ketones and your body starts burning fat, because there's no carbs, there's no sugar, there's nothing in your diet. Mr. Marshmallow is sneezing. And so it will be really hard the first 3 days. And then after that, it'll even out. If you get hungrier, you're free to snack on as many green veggies as you want. Also sugar-free Jell-O, things like that. But again, I didn't snack on anything else, and you lose weight pretty quickly. This is a really good thing, especially because it tastes so good, and this has all the vitamins and nutrients and everything in it that you need, because this is made to be very, very low calorie. And I did cheat in the end. I had an extra piece of chicken breast that I wasn't supposed to have, maybe a wing or two that was about that big. It didn't do me any damage, but yeah, I mean, Logan offered me Subway, and I turned down Subway, and I said, no, I've come this far. If I'm going to cheat, it's going to be something that's that's allowed just a little bit more of it, so I had a little bit more meat, but that was actually, in the end, it was all right. And I lost, I'm not quite sure how much I lost. I remember 5 pounds in a week or something like that, or 2 weeks. I don't really know. It varies how much you lose, how closely you stick by it as well. And you know, don't load up in the salt, because with my, you can't eat corn, but I ate a lot of green beans and broccoli. With green beans, I put shit tons of butter and salt, which helps you retain water, which wasn't very good. So my real weight loss came after my surgery. But if you stick to the diet plan really well, I've seen people lose 50 plus pounds on it very quickly. And it works really good. And it's easy to keep up with. It's easy to continue doing. And so, yeah, I highly suggest that. Another tip that I was told was don't drink with your meals, not just after surgery, but in general. Because when you drink, when you're eating, aside from just wetting your throat so the food can go down, if you actually drink with your meals, you're pushing your food through your system that much faster and you're getting hungrier that much quicker. So you drink before your meals, or you wait till about an hour after you're eating before you start drinking again. And that way the food has had time to actually sit in your system and you stay full and you feel full and you don't get hungry again that quickly afterwards. The last thing I have to suggest is just what I was told from the exercise consultant the one time I saw her, is move around, but don't think of exercise as exercise, because that's where you will fuck yourself up. I was beating myself up saying, oh, I don't exercise, because I have yet to exercise. Honestly, I don't exercise at all. I do go out with Logan. I move around a lot more than I did before my surgery. Logan's mom gave us, you can't see it from here, gave me a little exercise walker machine. So I'm going to start using that. But anything that gets your heart beating and gets you moving around, walking, dancing, cleaning the house burns a lot of calories if you have like a full house clean. Anything that's moving around and gets you, your muscles going and your heart beating, that's considered exercise. You have to think outside the box, and you can't think to yourself, if I'm not lifting weights, if I'm not doing jumping jacks, jumping rope, running a marathon, then it's not exercising, it's nothing. That's not true. Anything is something. And so that's what I've had to tell myself, like, fuck, I haven't gone out, I haven't done anything, but I walked for like 5 hours yesterday. You know, I mean, that's a lot of exercise, and it's getting out of the house, moving around. That's where you've got to start. Sure, later on you can build up to going to a gym or actually doing like real exercising, but if you're completely unfit and you're really needing help, the first step is to get yourself moving and to stop, can't believe brain fart. Well, whatever. It's like when you put up a block and you stop yourself from doing something because you've talked yourself out of it before you've gotten started. God, if you guys can think of the word, please tell me, because this is going to drive me nuts. Anyway, you've got to make sure that you don't stop yourself before you get started, because you've been putting too much thought into it. If you're getting out, if you usually just sit in bed and do nothing, and you got out and you walked to the store, that right there is something more than you've previously done. Every little bit counts. Every little bit will help. So you just got to kind of get started. Make that first move, get up, do something, clean the house, walk around the block, walk to the mailbox, go on a walk with your significant other or a walking buddy or friends, or you know what I mean? Dance around the living room or something. I mean, I don't really do anything, but when me and Logan go out, I don't bitch and complain about how far the bus stop is anymore and stuff. And like, the bus stop from here is about 2 miles. And so that's a pretty good walk just to go out and do. And I do it just fine. And then it's a bus ride, and then more walking, and then more walking, and more walking. It's quite a bit of walking whenever we do go somewhere together, which admittedly isn't very often, but I do things around the house and stuff and try to get moving a bit. And now that I have this machine, I'm going to try that as well. So that's another tip. Just, you can't think of it in terms of a specific kind of exercise. You have to think of any movement that you do as exercise. That is what the fitness person told me. So that's not me saying it. That's what she has told me. Exercise consultant is what she was called. And yeah, just try to cut out as much sugar and carbs as possible. Get this if you can. Stick with this. This will help you. And don't drink with your meals. So hopefully those tips helped. It's all I could think of. I'm really sorry. I'm not a fitness-minded person. I'm not big on exercise. I'm not big on moving around. I'm not big on diets. I'm not big on anything. I'm real weak-minded, and I'm just like, I want, but I can't eat now. So that's what helps me, because otherwise I'd probably be gobbling down everything. I just snack on cheese and cherries. This right here is my breakfast. It's just a couple of cherries and a plum. And it was one piece of chicken wing that I already ate. And then I have some cheese here, which I probably eat one little slice of. And then I have some Swiss cheese here. And I probably have one slice of that. But this would be, that's my all day meal right there. That's probably what I'd eat for the entire day. So, yeah, that's about all. Drink lots of water, because of course, when you feel thirsty, they say it's too late, and a lot of times you get hungry and your stomach's grumbling, and it's not actually hunger, it's thirst that disguises itself or presents itself as hunger. And so you eat when you just think that you're hungry, but you're not, you're actually thirsty. So try drinking first and watch the calories that you're drinking, because things like this that I drink, these, you'll be drinking your calories, and this has 180 calories per serving. I've had this for about a week, and then I let Logan drink. He drank like about that much of it yesterday. This here would take me so long to drink that it'll rot before I can finish it, because I don't drink a lot of sweet stuff. The tea that I drink is sugar-free, has nothing in it, just green tea. Or water. My one vice is milk. I love milk, and that, of course, has a lot of calories and stuff in it. But I don't drink a bottle a day like I used to. Now a bottle will also sometimes run me until where it's gonna expire and I have to give it away. So you just gotta watch your intake and hidden areas that you might be adding calories where you aren't thinking about it. If you chew gum, if you suck on mints, if you like your coffee, if you have an ice cream cone, it might not always be in your food. It might be in other things. So there are lots of little things to look out for, lots of traps. And of course, if you take in lots of salt like I do, you will be retaining water like I do. So that's another thing to look out for. But I hope this has helped, my very simple and self-explanatory tips here. It's all I know. I did promise to make this video, because I keep getting asked, and I'm sorry I'm a couple days late on it. But again, I hope this helped you, and I will see you soon. Bye-bye.